carbon dioxide emissions from the burning of coal, oil, and gas, and the emission of other greenhouse gases like methane and nitrous oxide, mankind has induced an unprecedented and unsustainable ongoing change of the global climate. This has already resulted in an average temperature increase of approximately 1 degree Celsius and an accelerated sea level rise of approximately 22 centimeters. Globally, it has also caused more extreme weather events, such as droughts, heavy rainfall, and wildfires. We are no longer in balance with our environment. Our current lifestyles are unsustainable, and if unchanged, will cause further irrevocable and irreversible damage for generations to come. In the Paris Agreement of 2015, nations worldwide agreed to take greater action against the impacts of climate change, to limit the global temperature rise to below 2 degrees Celsius, and to ideally keep the temperature rise below 1.5 degrees Celsius. The EU is the first set of countries to develop a legal framework for becoming climate neutral by 2050, and in February 2020, the EU passed an according climate law. In order to achieve the goal of climate neutrality by 2050, the global economy must become climate neutral. But what does it mean to be climate neutral, and how do we get there? Being climate or carbon neutral is not the same thing as being completely emission-free. It means we achieve a net total of zero emissions by building a society where man-made emissions are avoided and reduced as much as possible, and action is taken to offset those emissions which are truly unavoidable. In other words, we need to radically reduce the emissions of greenhouse gases to a level equal to the annual removal rate of greenhouse gases from the atmosphere. Measures currently in place and those planned are, however, not sufficient to reach the goal of climate neutrality. There's a few major strategies for bringing our greenhouse gas emissions into balance. We must replace our current use of fossil fuels, such as coal, oil, and gas, with renewable energy technology that harnesses the energy of the sun, wind, and earth core. This is considered a mitigation strategy, or one that reduces the amount of total emissions by avoiding emissions through the use of renewable energy. Mitigation strategies should be prioritized in the race for climate neutrality, because reducing our baseline greenhouse gas emissions is the most effective way to reach climate neutrality. It is clear that renewable energy production is increasing globally. Due to successful research and development in this area, renewable energy technologies have already become economically competitive with conventional fossil fuel-based technologies. In the coming years, their costs will sink further due to scaling effects. The increased use and greater expansion of renewable technologies results in decreased costs due to increased production efficiency and technological improvements. This development enormously increases the chances of reaching climate neutrality by 2050. One important step towards this goal is to cut down subsidies that still support the fossil fuel industry. In 2017, the value of these subsidies worldwide was more than the total global investments in renewable energy technologies. While the global value of subsidies for fossil fuels was over $340 billion, the total investments in renewable energy technologies at the time was only $325 billion. Targeting economic lifelines for high-emission industries will reduce their output, growth, and role in energy provision, thereby reducing greenhouse gas emissions. In order to reach climate neutrality by 2050, there are several additional key interventions that must be implemented as soon as possible. The first is implementing a global carbon tax, the goal of which is to provide the economic incentive to shift towards renewable energy use and sustainable alternatives that result in as little greenhouse gas emissions as possible. Second is to implement a systematic shutdown of all existing coal, gas, and oil power plants. Further, investment should be funneled into research for renewable energy technologies and enhancing energy efficiency. There should be increased focus on the development and preservation of carbon sinks, which function to remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. This can be achieved in a number of ways, including promoting climate-positive agriculture and afforestation. Furthermore, preserving wetlands and other environments that naturally store carbon dioxide is paramount to enhancing our chances of reducing the atmospheric levels of carbon dioxide. Finally, there should be increased development of technologies for artificial carbon sequestration, bringing human activities into balance with what the natural environment can withstand is essential to building a happy and long future for society. With a combination of strategic measures and global cooperation, we will reach the goal of global climate neutrality by 2050.